started playing basketball really young, like maybe 6 or 7. I got so good at it. I always had such big dreams to do big things with basketball, and so I became relentless. I wanted to make it to college, Division I scholarship, you know, and then after that, I wanted to make it to the WNBA and professional in Europe. I accomplished most of those goals already. The only goal I haven't accomplished is making it to the WNBA. Some of the challenges that I face is just the amount of pay that we receive. You know, it's widely known that us female athletes are receiving way less than the male. It's extremely low. Besides that, there's really no more challenges. I mean, I love the game. I could play it, I think, forever.
New York is the mecca of ballroom, is where it started. So it's always an exciting event for New York City when we throw balls. It's always highly anticipated. I had a friend from elementary school. We linked back up in high school, went to the same high school. And my friend came into class one day with this gold effect, like this costume, and he was like, yeah, I'm gonna walk a ball. I'm like, what's a ball? And he was like, you know, they Vogue and stuff like that. And so he took me to my first ball. That was about 2008, and I fell in love with it. My role in the community, I commentate and I host balls all around the world. What's challenging to me is having to deal with the different personalities in one room, having to do a ball with over 1,000 people, and just dealing with so different energies and different people. I think it's just mind-blowing. And yeah, it's a vibe. I love it.
It was really by accident, to be fair, right? My dad actually got me into the sport of boxing because I just always in a lot of trouble, always fighting. He was definitely like kind of getting annoyed about it. It was to the point where he was kind of afraid that it was going to be to a point of like no return. Either I was going to be in jail, you know, I was going to end up, you know, someone's going to kill me or whatever it was. So, and he figured, you know, just to keep me busy, and I've always been an athlete, he decided to put me into boxing, and it was uphill from there. One thing about boxing, I've told people this over and over again for years. Boxing is the ultimate truth serum. There's you know, some people can act a certain way outside the ring. You can try to carry yourself a certain way, talk a certain way. But when you're under those lights and when that bell rings and you have someone in front of you, that's when everyone will know who you really are. I love anime. I like, especially during training camps, I watch a lot of anime during training camps. I think I do get inspired by, I guess, the, you know, sometimes the storylines, the fight scenes, you know, and sometimes my style and what things I do in the ring can get inspired by a certain anime characters. I definitely want to be world champion one day. That's the goal I'm aiming for now.
It's an art for real. Like, a lot of people don't see it that way because it's like seen as very like taboo and like underground, but it's a lot of beauty in it, a lot of communities. It's a sisterhood for real. Like, you can actually find beautiful people and make great connections. Mm-hmm. There's such a negative light on like dancing, I feel like. Like, even to this day, it's not all bad. there's a lot of weird shit that happens, you know. It's an extreme place. It's more what's it called? It's a lot more risk. You know, even though there's a lot more profit, there's a lot more risk. But yeah, you learn a lot. There's a lot of lessons. That's one big thing.
Honestly, like, dancing is great. The club comes with its like positive and negatives, but the sisterhood allows you to like really be able to heal from it. It does show you a lot how like men and women use their sexuality for like good or bad. But it's up to you as like the entertainer, which route you take it in and how you control it. It teaches you a lot about boundaries, personal boundaries, 100%.
Most definitely.
Like inside and out, like. And I think it's also changed my perspective on like sex work in itself. And like, when I was younger, I may have because I come from a very religious family as well. Sex work is like, yo, you're the devil if you're doing that. Mm. But it's taught me to see another side, even like of religion, like spirituality. Like, mm-hmm. I'm very much like, I protect myself at all costs while going to work, whether it's like taking herbs with me, taking agua de flor, crystals, lighting my candle, praying, mm-hmm. praying while I'm at work, you know, because you are like very abundant and you attract what you want. Mm-hmm. So you have to keep that mindset. So we go through a lot of like, as young women, life-changing experiences and just like, and a lot of us, like, we're financially independent as well. Like, we're paying for our own apartments. We're mm-hmm. feeding ourselves. Like, yep. people have a misconstrued idea just because we're dancers that we make $1,000 a night, that we make the most, that men just throw their money at us when it's, like, we're playing a game of chess all night. Mm-hmm. Like, you are wearing a mask all night. And I like that mask in a way. It's empowering. But it's also, like, we have to do a lot of psychological play as well. So it takes a toll on like us that we have to force ourselves, take a month off, take a week off. But as freelancers, we get to do that as well, mm-hmm. you know?
It's a blessing.
Yeah, it's a blessing. Like we can make that money and leave for as long as we need.
Like the goal is to get out the club, you know, make the money that you need for your goal and get out. Cause it gets addicting.
Yeah, mm-hmm. that fast money is addicting. Sometimes I won't even notice I'm working 4, 5, 6 nights in a row because I'm just so excited that I know I can make money. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes we spend it quick too. If you want to get out the club, because I still want to dance. I want to become one of like the best pole dancer I could become. Same. You know, like I don't want to stop dancing just because I'm outside of the club. I want to mm-hmm. do events. I want to do videos.
Yeah.
I would like for it to be still an art form for me, but as for being in the club, I give myself 2-3 years yeah. and I'm done.
Like, I'll be dancing my whole life, just not in the club.
Yeah, just not in the club. Not dealing with men at 25 no. trying to like tell them, go to the fucking ATM. Like, the fuck are you talking about? You came into the strip club with no money. It's not really about really how much you have here as much as everybody thinks. It's how you like show up, you know? I feel like New York is really like ground and bred in like community. Like, I don't know, I've grown up in New York my whole life, and, like, although it's a little bit different now, and we understand why now that we're older, how it's have changed politically, socially, although I don't think New York has ever been at its best when it comes to, like, social situations such as police brutality and, like, racism and, like, just classism. But as for right now, it's still just like one of the best thriving cities.
He just sound like a 50-year-old Cameron.
He does, but it's good.
His freestyles is fine, but he always been slow. But his recent freestyles have been fire though.
Yeah.
Like, super old school horse and carriage what? Cameron type shit.
Oh, yeah.
That was one of his joints. But Harlem as a whole was like kind of wild, like Mace. Mm. It was all kind of going in back in the day type shit.
Facts. Harlem as a whole. What if I said Harlem was a hole?
Damn,
that's kind of foul.
That's wild. Harlem's not a hole.
Yeah,
big Queens. Mm. You know what I mean?
Big Queens.
Yeah. Oh, he just copped the water.
God, nigga, I've been seeing fucking water. You know what? This is a slaughter.
Uh-huh.
I'm tired of this shit. Electrical
tape around
your daughter. You know what time it is?
Ooh.
I came through to show you how I give your
mom a
biz.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You look
like a llama bean.
Mm.
Electrical tape around my daughter. Let me tell you what the prisons did to your father.
I was saying. What's up?
I'm crying.
What's up?
Bro, y'all
I learned how to play chess on Rikers.
Uh-huh.
5 years prior, I was learning Super Mario Strikers on the Nintendo GameCube. Uh-huh. They didn't have that in the cells. I was in the box. I wouldn't blame you. You couldn't blame me.
He did a scheme on I was in a box, yeah. The Nintendo GameCube. Yeah. This nigga's stupid.
All right, you dragged it.
You didn't think that far.
Nah, he's stupid. What's up?
What you made the only at? Thing I drag yeah. is...
Where the,
What?
Where the ball is at?
It surely was my legacy. I grown from the bus, whipping my hoop. You know my seats would always burn from the sun. Mm-hmm. I know I'd never drive in silence. My brakes will let the block know. Fumes from the E-tanks, we still on the road. Mm. Oil leaks on the block, working vault by Seattle. Put the hop turnstiles in the moment of the rocks. But my fit ain't on the canvas, though. My Tim's in the exhibit. Let this younger get the same air time. You give quit it. See a black boy ringing red alarms to get attention. Instead of seeing him at his lowest, you just throw him in detention. Then we get repressed and inventive. You should lock up your old ideals. I feel it's the only way to build back. Meal tap, I ain't had no Lunchables to pack. Then he tripped through the scanners, weeding out the hammers. He ain't wanna have it, but he needed for protection. In the day he leave the school, he gonna wish he was arrested. Mm-hmm. New depression was a killer born. Knees to the minister. Mm. Pops with his many flaws. Mm. Hospital, many calls. Mindset is in his drawer. Mindset is in a pause. Cops put it at his jaw. Lock sitting in the stall. Light from the ground up. Niggas shot from the top that they doubt us. Damn. And they gone in the morning.
Skeleton, we made it. You know my secrets. Why don't you need it?